standing clear. Your life right now appears to be full of confusion. Your life right now appears to feel like nothing that you do prospers. But that's because you're going through a transformation. God has to blind you in order for you not to see, so you can start seeing.
That's right.
What does that mean? You have depended on what you see with your natural eyes too long. God is blinding what you see in the natural because he needs you to see in the spirit. What do you mean? You focus on what you are capable of doing. God is trying to get you to the point of being to surrender and allow him to do what he has ordained to do in your life. Watch this. Watch this. Watch this. You say, how can God use me? I used to be a homemonger. Man, no use. I'm still a homemonger. I'm using drugs. I still like to get high and taste every now and then. I'm lying every now and then. I steal all the time. How can God use me? That's why God had the blind Saul. Because when God removed the scales from his eyes, he changed from Saul to Paul. God is trying to get you from changing your name. Instead of you being called a liar, God wants you to start saying you are the same one. Instead of you saying what you don't have, God wants to change your ways to what you do have. But he has the blind. Oh, thank you, Lisa. Let me stop you. You're wondering why some of those people in your life that you thought was your homeboy, your dog, your best friend, your ride and die, and now they've turned their back on you. That's part of your blindness. God wants you purposely to get your ride and die out of your life. He purposely got you blinded so you can get some of those friends out of your life. Why? Because God is a jealous God. He really don't want you to put anything before him. That's right. I said, some of you wonder why did he leave me? I gave him everything he wanted. I did everything he wanted to do, and he still walked out of my life. Guess what? Part of the blindness, he wanted that old stuff out so he could bring some new stuff in. But you got to understand, God is trying to change your name. Pick up your cross and follow. Sometimes the way out of something is through it.
Yep.
Come on, come on.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Some of you spend so much time trying to avoid what the inevitable is. You're trying to go around, and God says you got to go. Why? Because if I go around it, I'm not going to learn enough to handle what's on the other side. So in order for me to really handle what's on the other side, I gotta go through some stuff for preparation for what God is trying to do. So you're crying, whimpering, hollering. Because some of this stuff, you just have to go through it. How about you watch it? Jesus prayed for the cup to pass from him. Nevertheless, thy will be done and not mine. You need to stop howling, stop crying, and just say, Lord, thy will be done. So, let me use earthly analogies. If I go fishing, and I am a fisherman, and I catch a catfish, that catfish is in his purest form. Once I take him off the hook, put him in my bucket, take my bucket home, put him on the table, I got two choices. Either to take him in his purest form or do the necessary preparation to really enjoy him the way he needs to be enjoyed. What am I doing? Watch this. So, I don't know about you, but I like my catfish fillet. Which means I got to take some of that bad stuff. What God is doing with your life right now? We've got a choice. We can either accept you in your purest form or get some of that bad stuff off. I've never really been a catfish, but I can only imagine if someone is pulling my skin off, it's going to be very painful. You want to know why you got so much pain right now. God is peeling away some dead stuff so he can fix you in your purest form. I can use you over here. I can do some stuff preparing you for the other side. What do I call me today? Pick up your cross and follow. And they took Jesus and led him away. And he buried his cross with fall into a place called the place of skulls, which is called in Hebrew, Golgotha. You got to understand that Jesus himself bared a cross. Now watch this. The cross that he bared wasn't for him. Because the Bible says he was without sin. So the cross he bare was for you and for me. That's why I get so uncomfortable. I can't say that. I get so uneasy when I see church folks treat Jesus any kind of way. About what he did. Bearing that cross, being ripped off that heel for your sins and mine. It shouldn't take much for you to be excited when you hear the name of Jesus. Why? I need some of y'all to do something. Y'all see anybody asleep, y'all need to hit them. So wait a minute here. Because there ain't nothing but the enemy trying to get you to sleep on what you need for your life. But look around right now. You got anybody in that, you need to hit them right now. Tell them to wake up in Jesus' name. Glory to God. Glory to God. Watch it. Thank you, sister. For the preaching of the cross, 1 Corinthians 1:18 says, for the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness. But unto us which are saved, it is power of God. When we take on the cross, it gives us power to do those things that we see that are impossible. Really impossible. Some of us say, Pastor, I hear what you're saying, but my life is so entangled right now. Situations just are so bad right now that I don't really know how I'm going to get out of it. I love God, I believe God, I trust God, but it just seems like things are just so bad right now. You heard me say about the fish. You got to understand, even in a bad time, you got to still praise God. Even in a rough time, you got to still praise God. Why?